In the last lesson, we focused on access control, but in particular, what we called discretionary access control. The idea there is that access control is about checking if the source of a request should be able to gain access to a resource. We know that who the user is because user comes and authenticates himself or herself. So in discretionary access control, we said whoever creates the resource is the owner of that resource. So the owner can also selectively grant access to other users. For example, Bob may both be able to read and write, and Charlie can either read or write, or maybe just has read access or something like that. So the idea of a discretionary access control model is that resources have owners who are users, and these owners get to decide, it's at their discretion, who else should be able to share these resources. In this lesson, we're going to examine if this model has any limitations or any problems. Are there situations where it's not going to do the job for us? And if that is the case, then what other kind of models do we need to develop to meet those applications or those needs that arise when we talk about access control?